just now?
Yeah. She's my wife.
All right, Kadri, send out pre-op labs and book an OR.
Dr. Krebs, I have to report this.
Well, you just told the chief. We should tell Dr. Pierce we're leaving, though, right? You know, close the circle. Hey, Dr. Pierce.
Hey.
Dean. Another Dean.
What's up?
I was wondering how that lady was doing. That poor kid's mom.
Oh, yeah, not good. There was too much damage to repair.
Wow, that's too bad. Just trying to pivot from that. Kind of set myself up badly.
Or?
I was wondering if you would like to get dinner with me sometime. Don't have to laugh.
No, I just. I had a fiance named Dean once.
This is going great. Ellie forced her coded again. We brought her back, but she's circling the drain.
I have to go. I am so glad we made it. So glad.
What the hell, Varev? Oh, glad you reported me. She did her job. You stabbed a patient?
Look, you said find a creative solution, right?
I didn't say commit assault or insurance fraud. I mean, if this is your way of getting out of being interim chief, congratulations. It'll likely get you out of being a doctor at all.
Look, I'm just kicking the job's ass before it kicks mine, like your mother said.
No, you do not get to use my mother's words against me.
Well, let me tell you something my mother used to say. Bats. There are bats everywhere, Alex, and they know everybody's phone numbers.
Bats. Bats everywhere. They know the numbers. That's so cool.
I just have no authority. I'm not her mother.
What are you?
I don't know. Her friend? Her sponsor, maybe? I'm trying to be whatever she needs.
She needs a damn mother, it sounds like.
So I should push it.
You're building a boat. A boat. It's what I used to tell Owen's dad. They're gonna sail away from us, I said. It's inevitable. Our job is to build a boat strong enough that when they decide to, they can get back to us safely.
Great. So I need to be firm, use tough wood, and hammer in the nails.
We're not building an actual boat. The boat is your relationship.
Right. No, I got it. Oh, thank you.
Let me ask you this. Are you and Owen back together? I can't tell him. He won't say.
I don't know. I think we're just kind of
raising some kids together or whatever. Lord.
Do you have an opinion either way?
Of course I do, dear. I'm his mother.
We think that it's time.
Time for what?
Max, the sun down. I'm gonna go check on Murphy. Okay?
Okay. This could be his last chance to say bye.
Please don't. This is too much for him. We mentioned it.
Travel's the best thing about being married to work. It's the trade-off for all this fast stuff working doesn't give
you. You travel a lot.
truly that, that is the most frustrating thing about dating. The single moms, there's such a need to speed things up. It's like by the end of the first date, they're talking marriage. Kids can make women so
desperate.
Well, I don't want to call it that. Yeah, you know what? I do want to call it that.
Are you even allowed to be up here?
Not really, but it's part of what makes it cool, right? Why don't you come out and see Tom?
I know she's not okay. I can tell. Why is my dad lying to me?
I wouldn't say he's lying, Max. He's just trying to. When I was in college, my mom went to go visit my sister in Italy. And one day, my sister calls me and she says, you have to come home right now. Mom's really sick. So I flew home, and when I got there, she had died of a stroke. But the truth is, she was already dead before my sister even called me.
Your sister lied?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she did. And believe me, Max, I was so mad at her. But I couldn't have you find out without me being there to hug you. And then I understood.
Is my dad ill?
No.
Is my mom gonna die?
No, Max, I just mean...
Is she dead already?
Max, no, I just mean it's hard to face the truth sometimes. It's scary, even for doctors, but Max... Max, wait! Max! Max, wait!
And he's not going to tell his kid until after she's already dead, when it's too late for him to say goodbye. You. Me? Yeah, you should answer this for me. If you see a disaster coming, and you have to break patient confidentiality to prevent it, don't you do that? Like, I should tell you, right? Them. Him.
Well, it's an oath.
And as wrong as it feels, is it your business? I hate people. So how did it go? Horribly. I liked him a lot. We found each other delightful. And I thought, hey, could it really be this easy?
How is that horrible?
Because then he said the one thing, that he hates kids, and that he finds single mothers desperate.
Right. Okay. Next time.
Right. I don't think there'll be a next time.
Don't give up.
For what it's worth, it sounds like a great date. But if he hadn't said that thing, you might have given it a go. And then he would have probably tried to hide his feelings, and the truth might not come out for months or years. So, but you found out there are good men out there, and you dodged a very slow bullet. I call that a good use. Thanks, Aurora.
Hey, Kiano.
I see a kid, 10 years old.
You've lost a child? I'm there.
I didn't lose a child. I'm looking for one. Oh, did you hear from Papa?
Just go find your kid.
Okay. Oh, Karina.
What?
You're a really good sister.
Blah, blah, blah. I know he'll grieve without a problem, and he doesn't have to.